Well, Fergie, as you know, pitching is the heart of any ball club, and we're lucky to have four of the best starters in the major league. Steve, Clancy, Leal, and Morgan. But you know what? What I'm looking for right now is a southpaw for the bullpen.
Hey, Skip, some lefty just showed up in camp. He's a big guy. You gotta give him a look.
And Skip, you mind if we get a look at something else besides all this field?
Bobby, why don't you let them go to the new Epcot Center at Walt Disney World Resorts?
Oh, Fergie, you're a prince.
He's a prince and I'm a frog.
Ah, come on, Bob. Is that a nice thing to say?
And who will we ask for, Froggy?
Well, Dave, you can ask for Catherine Swing. She's the hostess of Just Like Mom, that Canadian game show for kids. You know, our big prize in that show is a trip for two to Disney World. And Catherine is there. She knows all about the new Epcot Center at Disney World. Have fun, eh, guys?
All right, guys, hit the trail.
Okay, thanks, Skip.
See you in a couple days.
Now, where's that new southpaw?
Spectacular. Dream that has become reality. This is the new Epcot Center, the continuing realization of Walt Disney's dream for a creative community of the future. Set outside Orlando, Florida, Epcot is divided into two areas, Future World and World Showcase, an architectural display of nine countries, including our own. And it's just a short hop for our Blue Jays to the heart of Canada's wilderness.
I wonder where these falls are at in Canada.
I don't know.
Hi, Kathy.
Hi, Kathy. How you doing?
Dave, how are you? Good. How are you?
Okay.
Gee, I wasn't sure you'd be able to get away from training camp long enough to visit Epcot. I'm glad you made it.
We're glad we made it. We needed a break.
Yeah, how's camp going?
Good.
Good. A little sore, but always happens every spring.
Sure. This area, the whole area, is called World Showcase. What we're heading into is the Canadian Showcase. They say that they have a Circle Vision film inside. And it's called O Canada. It sort of shows the cities, countryside, special events. Might be kind of fun to start there. You're practically Canadians now anyway.
Sounds good to me. Let's do it.
Do they always ride horses? This is Canada, huh?
A lot of open land.
It's really incredible to see so much space that's not being used. Of course, we have some big plans for that open land. At least that's what our government in Ottawa keeps telling us.
Between this wind and that beautiful reproduction of the Chateau Laurier, I feel like I'm in Ottawa.
I tell you, that sure is beautiful. I hope we get the chance to see that up in Ottawa.
Be a nice drive from Toronto if you have a chance. If we look across the man-made lake at the rest of World Showcase, too, we can see China, Germany, Italy, the American adventure.
Well, you know, this whole setup is pretty realistic. Here we are, standing in Canada, and right across the lake is the United States.
That's right.
And here at Epcot, it's called the American Adventure, and for good reason. Set inside this colorful mansion, America's hard-won past and promising future are brought to life in a presentation featuring audio animatronics. They're kind of human-looking robots. Of course, the legacy of inspired dreams remains the key to this country's history.
You know, part of the feeling of the American adventure starts right here in the lobby with the quotations all around us and the works of art. All of the paintings are originals and they were commissioned specifically for the lobby.
Like this portrait of the American astronauts.
Here we have one well-known quotation. It's funny when you remember back to history in school. If we'd read that quotation in a book, it wouldn't have meant anything, yet here it really applies. It's a philosophy that you're working with.
Well, I think this is very similar to what Bobby Cox believes. Last year we took a lot of chances, a lot of hit runs, a lot of stealing. I think we accomplished a lot as a result of that.
I'd say so. He tried to let me steal four times.
Live and learn.
Why don't we go take a look at the film and really get the true spirit of the American adventure?
Sounds great.
Good.
I'm up for that. Okay.
Good evening, Mr. Jefferson. Have you finished the new draft yet?
Those are new drafts all over the floor, Dr. Franklin. It seems one stroke of this pen brings two changes from Congress. I told you John Adams should have written this.
Oh, by his own admission, you can write circles around him.
Mr. Adams has not been prisoner in this law for 17 days. I shall continue tomorrow.
Some trying times. Things get better, though.
The
band. Part of history.
Of course, now we're a whole lot smarter. Now Congress wants to trim down the Navy, so it'll fit into the bathtub, too. You know, it seems to me like we're the only nation in the world that waits till we get into a war before we start getting ready for it.
Learn more here than I did in school.
You're always playing baseball in school.
What do you think of our America now?
I think the founding fathers never dreamed of an America like this.
Of course not. We weren't dreamers. We were visionaries. That is why our Constitution withstands the rigors of time.
Easy now, Dr. Franklin. This nation's still just a youngster, don't you know? Why, some countries have been around for 500 centuries. We're barely into a third.
That's true, but look what we've accomplished in that tiny span of time.
My dear doctor.
Mark Twain looks like an old manager.
And he looks like he's managed the Blue Jays.
Of course, the American adventure only set the stage, and I mean set the stage, for the streets of Italy right next door. Here we come across the Bologna Players, a Renaissance experience that Dave and Ernie just couldn't pass up.
Pretend like I do.
Whack-a-doo.
Yes. Well, when this Bobino hears about that Bobino, this Bobino gets indignant. Hey! It's on the inside. It's on the inside.
I like you, buddy, but don't quit your day job, okay?
And then he marches up to Bobino, huh? And he rips off his nose.
Oh! Ah! He really did it. Give me that thing. You nasal destroyer, you. What a ripoff.
And then he goes back over to Alicia. He puts one arm around her, and he points back at Bobino. And he says, oh, great imposter.
Oh, great imposter.
Now, they get married. They live happily ever after. They get married. They live happily ever after. And me, Epcota?
Si.
I ran off with this cute guy right here.
Oh.
And that's the story of the great imposter. Pietro di Bologna, a song that's a silly story.
Now you've seen it, Dave Steve can be just as nosy as the rest of us. Exploring the wonders from one country to another at Epcot gives you an incredible cultural experience in a short space of time. But when you've got a pitcher and a catcher on your hands at high noon, then you've got two hungry heroes in King Arthur's court.
It was about time we stopped for lunch. I was getting pretty hungry.
I feel like we've been over the whole world.
Hey, this is just what I needed. Bobby Cox saw me now. I'm already 6 pounds overweight. All right, I'm eating some more.
Yeah, but this stuff's good for you.
Can't beat fish and chips.
Traditional. Mm-hmm. We're in England, and here we are eating fish and chips.
I could stay here all day eating fish and chips, but there's so much to see and do in so little time. I'm looking forward to seeing some more.
This past winter, I traveled all across Canada, and it really, you know, it kind of touches home because you, when you visit these places, you can actually see them, you know, see them with your own eyes, and it's, they did a good job here.
Well, I was proud of the American Showcase myself.
Sure. We've got to be.
Sure, anyways.
Yes,
we've got to be.
I felt it was kind of a little history refresher course, going over the different periods of time. Kind of brought back memories.
You know, Kathy, I've really enjoyed seeing all the different countries here. I'm looking forward to seeing something in a future world.
Well, if we can just keep you from ordering more fish and chips, we'll get there pretty quickly. Well, Ernie, it doesn't take long for wishes to come true around this place. We're right in the center of Future World now. And you see that big thing up there? Now, if you miss that baseball, you're going to have a rough time this season.
It's true. Hopefully I can hit something that big.
Well, I hope you can, because that's Spaceship Earth, and that's where you're heading now.
And just what is that?
It's a moving exhibition where you get into a time machine and you go all through the history as well as the future of communications.
Sounds interesting.
Take a look.
All right.
This place is really high tech.
I'll tell you what, Dave, I've been to a lot of places, but I've never seen anything like this before.
Dave, Ernie, this is the energy exchange presentation of Communicore.
Well, I know Ernie doesn't know anything about this, so exactly what is energy exchange all about?
Energy exchange is a presentation that focuses on present energy sources as well as alternate energy sources.
Well, let me ask you this, Kat. I know Dave doesn't know about this, but what is that above you right there?
That fancy-looking little contraption is called a solar parabolic dish, and it has the potential to generate enough solar energy to run 8 to 10 homes.
That many?
That's what you call high-tech. But high-tech has only come a long way because of a guy named Edison and his interest in electricity.
Dave, look at this over here. Think your arm's in shape?
You mean this arm?
Yeah, look at this thing. It says, for dollars worth of electricity, you've got to generate this thing. You have to turn that crank for 17 days and generate 40 watts.
Let's see what I can do. Like I told you, you mean this arm? Here's some of the actual drill bits they use, Ernie.
Tell you what, Dave, that looks like one of your biting sliders right there. Look at this thing right here. This is what every pitcher needs is a blowout prevention.
I've got one right here, Ernie.
Dave, Ernie, how do you feel about energy exchange now? Do you think you know what it's all about?
I think so. It's like Dave's throwing one of his best fastballs at us.
So I guess I'm a type of energy source then, huh?
Only when you have your good stuff.
Well, Dave, we'll see how your pitching compares to the power in our next pavilion. Now, this pavilion is called Universe of Energy, and it's really different than the energy exchange that we've already seen. It focuses on fossil fuels and how they were made. It's really a showplace for the imagination. One of the exciting parts is a journey right through a primeval swamp.
Is this the place really where all the dinosaurs are at?
Right, the dinosaurs are right inside there, right through those Latin doors. So why don't you go in, have your journey through the swamp, have a good time, and I'll meet you back at the big fountain at Communicore.
What, are you scared?
Just about that much.
Oh.
Have a good time.
Okay.
I'll see you later.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Go, Ern, there's no lines. This guy's got some tobacco hanging out of his mouth.
Where's that power heater we've been looking for?
Could use them.
Well, I'm glad you made it back alive. What did you think of those dinosaurs?
Oh, well, they weren't all that scary, but they were pretty big.
Sure.
I tell you what, guys, I wish Bobby Cox was with us here. I think we found our power heater that we need.
In there? Whatever you say.
Speaking of Bobby Cox, I think we better get back to camp.
I think you're right.
Well, I'm glad we were able to come over. It's been fun. I've enjoyed it.
We had a real good time.
I enjoyed it.
Okay, well, why don't we head back to the monorail and get you on your way?
All right.
Good.